rate gains. A little bit of a pause, was it? A bit of a breather for investors?
Unfortunately, it wasn't a good day for the market, and that's what technical analysts will be trying to figure out, whether this is a pause that refreshes or whether we are going to see another move down. We have seen a pretty good run, so not surprising to see a bit of a pullback, but I guess the big question is whether it is part of a bigger movement. So the market down by 1.2%. It was quite a bearish day, as you can see from the intraday graph behind me. We did close near the lows of the day. But if we have a look across the market, losses across all sectors except for the staple sector, which did manage to end flat. The energy sector was the worst, down by 2.7%, and overnight we did see oil inventories increasing last week in the US, the biggest market for oil. If we have a look at the property sector, down by 1.9%, and we also saw the material space off by 1.8%. So altogether, some heavy losses on the Australian share market, and of course earnings in season, and some of earnings very much in focus, earnings season. And if we have a look at some of the companies, I guess some of the highlights for me were ABC or Adelaide Brighton, saying that the first half it was hit by the weak housing market, but the second half they're expecting to see an improvement. So that stock almost up by 4%. APN Media having an absolute shocker of a day. Its stock was down by a massive 12.4%, reaching an all-time record low after its result. And I think the quote of the day has to come from the ASX CEO Robert Elston, who said volatility is the new normal.
Bit about today, Julia Lee. Foster's, we spoke about it yesterday, of course, SAB Miller coming back, well, not really coming back, but just retabling, if you like, this $4.90 a share offer. Look, what did you make in particular of the price movement in Foster's share price, well, holding above that $4.90 price, closing on $5?
If we have a look at Foster's, I think there's a number of things that are happening around the globe to do with this bid. And first of all, if we have a look at the state of the beer market, well, we've seen a couple of profit downgrades now coming through from Carlsberg, as well as from Kirin, saying that that they are expecting to see a bit of a weaker beer market, so adjusting their forecasts for the year downwards. If we have a look at Carlsberg share price, it was down sharply, saying the demand coming through from Russia is weaker than expected. And here in Australia, we are also seeing the beer market struggling, especially in Victoria, which is Foster's largest market for beer. So if we have a look at what's happening in terms of Foster's, what we're seeing is a declining margins for the first time in 10 years, and we're probably seeing a shrinking in market share. So Tuesday is going to be important, because that's when Foster's comes out with its result, and the market expecting to hear of Foster's plan to try and turn some of these things around, battle the difficult beer market, try and grab more market share and improve its margins as well. But I think the reason why Foster's share price went up today was the merger and acquisition activity that we've been seeing. And if we have a look, we did see that takeover for Independent Liquors coming through, and that provided Foster's with a bit of a boost. We also saw some fund managers coming out today, Perpetual being one of them, saying that they wouldn't be happy to accept that $4.90 bid, and that SAB Miller would have to raise a bid. So Foster's closing at $5 above that $4.90 bid price, and up today on the back of all that was happening.
Now, I've been joined in studio by Francesco to see AMP. Their shares closing up about, well, over 2.5%. But on the, like, the, I suppose, the headliner, NetPat down 18%. You wouldn't think there was all that much to get too excited about, but drilling down, investors are impressed.
I think that's what it was about for AMP's result. It always was going to be a difficult result to process, and that's because of its acquisition of AXA Asia Pacific. But once you take out some of the one-off costs, then the result coming in ahead of expectations. And I guess the big thing that the market was watching for in terms of AMP was how the integration of AXA was going. We saw the synergies for the year being raised up to $140 million, so that was seen as a positive as well. But if we have a look at AMP's business, a large part of it is that stable earnings, which does flow through. In the last few weeks, we have seen AMP's share price being sold down quite heavily, so not surprising to see a bounce back there. So we have seen a short-term bounce, but really for a longer-term uptrend to continue in AMP stock, it is still a wealth manager. So we need to see confidence returning to the market, an uptick in the market, an uptrend in the market, which will be a key turning point for AMP. So the share's doing well today, but I went back and had a look at the all-time high for AMP shares, above $28 back in 1998, so a fair way from that price, trading around that $4 mark. But for today, one of the best performers in the market, really positive about that integration with AXA.